रेडी 3, 2, 1 स्टार्ट द डेंजर दैट मिसलीडिंग और फॉल्स इंफॉर्मेशन poses to society has been grimly demonstrated during the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic full stop. Despite the deadly threat from the virus, many people's response across the world has often been shaped by misinformation fed through digital platforms full stop. This has either made them trivialize the disease or resort to cures without any basis in science and only because they were circulated in social messaging as a remedy full stop new paragraph. Vaccine hesitancy in many parts of the world has also largely been driven by rumor and conspiracy theories full stop. This prompted the World Health Organization early in the pandemic to coin the term infodemic to refer to the flood of information and exponential spread of fabricated content full stop. The head of WHO, Tedros Adhanom, declared, "We are not just battling the virus, we are also battling the trolls and conspiracy theorists that push misinformation and undermine the outbreak response full stop." Top UN officials repeatedly warned of the grave social and health ramifications of the proliferation of misinformation and underlined the need to immunize the public against false news full stop new paragraph. While the global health crisis has seen a stream of false stories, the reality is that fake news is all around us today full stop. This presents new challenges to social stability in what has been called the post-truth era, a term that emerged a few years ago, full stop. It refers to a phenomenon itself not new that is generally described as one where facts are discarded and criteria for establishing the truth are contested, full stop. Instead, there is a prevalence of views that only align with people's personal predilections or emotions, full stop, new paragraph. Why has fake news become so common today, question mark? Is it really so new? What explains its pervasiveness now, question mark? How damaging are the ramifications of a post-facts environment, question mark? Fake news is, of course, not new. Fabrications and untruths have always been around, full stop. So have efforts to manipulate the truth. Fact fudging has antecedents in propaganda, long used to manipulate opinion for political aims, full stop. Propaganda comprising deceptive narratives has usually been deployed by states or political leaders and aimed at enemies abroad or opponents at home, full stop. Disinformation has been used by countries against adversaries throughout history, full stop. What distinguishes fake news from propaganda is that individuals and non-state actors are now using it with abandon in the digital age, full stop. This makes it unprecedentedly pervasive, full stop.